Hi viewer, I welcome you to Redeem TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Business Studies Form 2, lesson number 18. The topic it is communication. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson objectives. We are going to describe the various forms and means of communications. Remember in our previous lesson, we talked about the first various forms of communication, that is oral or verbal communication. And today we want to look at the written communication. Now, when we talk about the written communication, it involves the transmission of messages through writing, that you must put it down in writing. Means of written communication may be letters. We also have the telegram. We also have the telex. We also have the fax mails. We also have memorandums. That are the ones that we refer to them as memo to pass information in the within the organization. Reports, circulars. We also have the agendas. We also have the minutes. So all these. If at all we talk about the report, it is writing a report on what something or on what has happened. You just put it down, write it down very fast, and then you report it. Circulars, for example, when you talk about the circulars, this is a report, a message that want to reach to the organizations or firms which are more than one. So you need to write a circular and then say it to them. Then you have the agendas. These are what is supposed to be discussed in the meeting. Then minutes. They are the ones that we write minutes. You need to write minutes of the meeting. Minutes of the meeting. Now, when we talk about the letters, you address letter to the right person who is supposed to receive the message. Telegram, the telex, and the fax mail, and also the memorandum. All these ones are written documents. Let us look at them. You can be able to see how they are distributed, the written communication. We have the emails. We also have the letters, instant memos. We also have the faxes. We also have the minutes and the memos. So you can have all that, which are written. Advantages. It can be retained for future reference. So whatever that has been written can be filed for future reference. For example, if a joint is a memo, that the CEO wanted it to give the rules to govern. So you just get that one is kept as a future reference and filed. Then some like letters are relatively cheap. So you are going to get that letter writing. Using letters as a means of communication, it is cheaper when it comes to when you compare with other means of communication, can be used as an evidence. This is the point where now you want to pass an information and you want to get an evidence. For example, you said face to face does not have any evidence. So you, if at all it is something that requires you to provide now an evidence, you can provide the written document. Can be addressed to many people. These are the written documents, either memos, either the circulars, that can be written CC, copy too. So you need to get that the letter or the written document can be addressed to more than one people in different organizations. Then it allows for inclusion of fine details. So you put down even the fine details, it is more detailed. It is not prone to distortion of message. So when passing now information to another person, you don't distort the message. You just give the way it was. Maybe you're the one who have been sent to take the message. You don't distort the message. It is received the way it was intended to be received. Disadvantages. It lacks personal appeal. So there is no that personal appeal, that convincing power, that presence. It is not there. It takes time to prepare and reach the recipient. For example, when it comes to red lighting and setting it, it takes time. Then immediate feedback may not be possible. So you don't communicate to the writer immediately. You don't communicate to the fax immediately. Email, you can read it after even 10 days. So you don't expect to get the feedback immediately. It does not offer room for persuasion and convincing. Activity. Discuss advantages and disadvantages of written communication. If at all you want reference, you can get the KLB 2011 Inventor Secondary Business Student Book 2, third edition. If at all you have any interest to get it, you have somewhere where you have not understood, you can get us through either SMS, you can also get us from the YouTube, you can get us from the Facebook and through the Twitter. Stay tuned to Erim TV.